Welcome to LC Engineering. Today we are going to do a video on how to adjust valve lash, set the valve lash on the 20R22R22RE engines. We're going to cover two different methods of doing this. The first one is going to be per the Toyota service manual, and the second method will be how we do it here at LC Engineering. The service manual recommends doing this after the engine is up to operating temperature. And then obviously if you're building a new engine, it's going to be done set cold, and then you can reset it after the engine is broken in and you have everything up to operating temperature. The first thing that needs to be done if this is in a vehicle is you need to disconnect your negative battery cable. Make sure the vehicle's safe, and then you're going to have to remove anything that's in the way, air cleaner, throttle cables, different things to where you can access the valve cover, and remove the valve cover to where you can get to where the rocker arms are underneath of that. So the first thing we're going to do is demonstrate how to find top dead center for the number one cylinder. What you're going to need to do, and if it's on an engine stand, obviously it's a lot easier than it's going to be inside the vehicle, but you're going to have, we're using a breaker bar with a 19 millimeter socket. You have to access the bolt on the crank pulley. You'll have your top dead center mark on your pulley. That's going to be lined up with zero. And what you're going to do is you're going to rotate the engine. The piston is going to be at top dead center. And you can tell it's at top dead center on the number one cylinder on the compression stroke. You can see in the valve or in the cam that both intake and exhaust are on the base circle of the cam, and the rocker arms will have a little bit of lash in them if you're doing a readjustment. If you're building a new engine, you may not have that until you adjust it and set it for the initial time. If you have a distributor in it, it's very easy to tell because the number one, on the cap where number one is marked and your rotor, it will point at number one. And then another thing that I'll tell you if you're on number one or not, is that the number four cylinder will be tight because those valves are actually opening. So the first method that you're going to do is you're going to have number one cylinder, you're going to be able to adjust both intake and exhaust on number one. You're going to be able to adjust the number two cylinder intake, and you're going to be able to adjust the number three cylinder exhaust. So that will be your first setup. And what you're going to need to adjust them, and these adjust at 8 thousandths on the intake, 12 thousandths on the exhaust. So you'll have to have feeler gauges to do this. A 12 millimeter wrench and a flathead screwdriver. So what you're going to do, if you need to make an adjustment, is you're going to loosen the nut. You'll get the wrench set up on it with the screwdriver. And on the intake side, it's going to be 8 thousandths. So what we're going to do is adjust it to where we can just slide the 8 thousandths feeler gauge with just a little bit of drag on it. And when you have it set there, you can just let the feeler gauge rest and lock the nut down. And just make it snug. And then when you're there, you should not be able to rock it when the feeler gauge is in there. Just a slight bit of drag. And then when you're finished, you'll have that amount of clearance in it. Same thing on the exhaust side. Except the exhaust side is going to use a 12 thousandths feeler gauge instead of the 8. Same thing. Very slight amount of drag. When you get that set, hold the adjusting screw in place with the screwdriver and snug the nut down. Number one cylinder now is complete. You can go ahead and do the remaining number two intake, number three exhaust, and that finishes the first set of them. Now what you're going to do is rotate the engine 360 degrees. So you'll go complete revolution, bring the timing mark back to zero. Now if it's in the car, you're going to have to use a flashlight or something so you can see down. It's a little more difficult, but the same method. Now what we can do is, now this is top dead center on number four, so you're going to be able to do both intake and exhaust on number four. You're going to be able to do the intake on number three and the exhaust on number two. And the same method, adjust them, and once that is finished, that covers all of them. So that is the first method, and that's how they recommend doing it out of the service manual. The way that we do it, because we're usually building engines on the stand, and they're new engine builds, so a lot of times we start off and we have zero lash because we have no place to start from. So what we do is the same method. Number one cylinder, top dead center on the compression stroke. The rotor is pointing at number one, where the cap would be. We can tell both valves are closed completely. Number four is tight, so I know that I'm on TDC on number one. Now I can adjust number one cylinder. Just the same method that we did. Now what I'm going to do is turn the crank 180 degrees to where the timing pointer now will be straight down. And if you need to make a mark, if you're building a new engine and you have it on a stand, you can make a mark straight across. And I'll bring that up. Now my rotor is pointing to number three, which is next in the firing order, 1342 on a Toyota on these engines. So now number three cylinder is at TDC compression stroke. So now I can adjust these. Again, 180 degrees, bring the timing pointer back to zero. Now I'm on number four, which is next in the firing order. I can adjust number four. And last will be number two, same thing, 180 degrees. So the timing mark now is straight down. Now number two is on the compression stroke, and I can tell because the rotor is pointing to where number two would be on the cap. Thanks for watching our video today. If you have any further questions, give us a call at LC Engineering. We also have tech notes covering valve lash on lcengineering.com. Or if you need to order any parts, go to lceperformance.com. Hopefully we can help you out with your project and keep you running down the road. Thank you.